Hey guys.
Nope.
My turn this time. Hey guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate.
My name is Tom.
And today we are going to check out this 2506.
Mate.
See, I already messed it up. I should have let you do it.
2506. I know. I know. But see, when you try to take over, you just mess up things.
Here we go.
So
guys,
this is the Rockwood Mini Lite 2506.
You'll love it.
So believe it or not, folks, we're coming into the late 2017 selling season. Can you believe, mate, already that we actually have newer 2018s, not the older 2018s?
Yeah, and this is one of them. So this has all the new features, like the new color. They have the new range finder.
What is the new color, mate?
This is like an oyster.
I was talking about the interior.
Oh, the interior.
I had to educate you on
mocha,
that.
It's mocha, Tom.
It's mocha with the driftwood on there.
Yep.
So that's the new color version from the Winston color that they had on the older 2018s. But some of the things that you're going to see is going to be the oyster exterior, and you're going to have the Wi-Fi range booster that's on this coach, along with the new colors. So you'll be able to determine, the new 2018s, because the new 2018s have that booster. The old ones do not. So can't wait to show it to you, and we're excited to move forward. So one of the cool features of this 2506, as you described earlier, mate, is that this one has a front kitchen in it.
Yeah, and not only a front kitchen, now this is not a storage area, just so you guys know. Whenever they have a panel here, that's just for...
So your water filter and your bypass valves will be back in this little compartment here.
And your water heater.
Yeah, but this one's gonna have a front kitchen in it, and it's got a nice big window in the front, something that's, I think has been asked for a long time, and Rockwood has definitely delivered on the 2506 with this particular coach. As we start in the back side of the coach, the back passenger side, mate wanted to switch it up, and I wouldn't let him because he'd throw off my consistency. Anyway, you're gonna have a two burner cooktop right here. Yeah. You're also gonna have a sink out here too that's attached to a drain, which is nice. It's not one of those, tubs where it's just a tub here and then you gotta throw the water out. This is actually connected to a drain. Both hot and cold water features on here. You're also gonna get a refrigerator out here. Now this is gonna run off a 110 power for you folks. Okay, this is not a gas or electric option, so you do need to be plugged in to be running this guy. And the way that this one slides in and out, you just unhook these latches here and you push it in and it locks down here. And then one of the things that you'll notice on the Mini Lites too, folks, now this is also new, is you're gonna have these magnetic holders on here, not the little plastic tabbies. So again, Rockwood is just delivering again as far as with their product and everything that they're doing with their brand.
Yeah, those plastics tend to break off after time. They get brittle in the sun.
They do. It's what you called weathering, and anytime you have plastic something, you're always going to have that issue. But switching to the magnetics is definitely a thumbs up by Rockwood.
Yeah.
Of course, you're going to get the outside grill. You have the prep station here. The grill here is connected to the gas line, so the gas line is going to come directly out of the coach for you. And you just plug this little bad boy right here, so you can grill up all your good fixings, the steaks, the fish, whatever you choose that you want to cook out here.
Well, and that's nice too. That way your camper isn't smelling like fish and steaks for the next three camping trips.
Well, it just makes you hungry if you do it that way.
Well, I don't like to sleep with my steak. That's the only problem.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, that's interesting to know. Octavio, let's make sure that we get that in the notes that he does not like to sleep with his steaks.
Hey, I'm just saying, I don't like my sleeping bag smelling like bacon.
No, I understand. Yeah, and there's a great storage compartment that we're going to show you on the backside that you can actually stow this grill in if you want to.
Yeah.
The TV that you get on the inside, of course, is going to come with a TV. It's going to come with an outside grill. So you can bring the TV from the inside of the coach and put this guy right here. So we have football season kicking off.
That's right.
So there's going to be a lot of things. You can have the barbecue out here going. You can watch your Bronco football or whatever sports team that you want to root for. You got a 110 power outlet and the coaxial cable connection right here.
And we're underneath this huge awning. I love
that
it expands the entire length of the coach.
Yep.
LED lights underneath. You also have your bug light right by the door, so you're not attracting the bugs inside your camper even though you have some lights on.
Yep, two marine grade outside speakers so you can listen to all your music out here. And this awning also has the adjustable elbows on here, which is what I like. Now I can't adjust them here because we're demoing this one. This one's actually on our north lot here we're doing the video on, but you got this bob wire here so I can't lower it. But you can adjust these elbows so you can pitch the slope left or right, keep the sun out of the out of your eyes, or shoot that water off in each direction depending on which way you want to go with it.
The other thing I like about these is it has the, instead of having a little hook that you have to be able to hold this door open, it has the built-in friction hinge. So what that is it's a little bit more resistant hinge so that you don't have to worry about hooking on it. The problem with the hooks is, one, they break.
Yeah, they do break.
And two, if you forget, a lot of times you'll rip it out of the wall and then you have two holes in the side of the camper that it's hard to get new screws in there that hold. And
yeah, and the friction door hinge, you can put it in any direction that you want to. You still have the screen door in here where you can have mate grab you an beverage, because he's going to be in there sleeping with his steak. Anyway, right. You can have him, hey mate, grab me a beer, and yeah. You know, that's what his job is when we go camping. Yeah. Anyway. One of the things too that you'll also notice, it does have the frameless windows on here. These frameless windows, of course, have you seen in all my videos, are cut directly and match specifically to this coach. Now they are much more energy efficient than the ones with the rubber grommets and the seals that you'll have to replace over time. So this gives it a cool look to the coach and better insulated. So great feature with the Rockwood there.
You know, for such a small coach, a lot of times outside storage is a huge issue. This one is actually one of the few that you get a lot of storage spots.
It's got a lot, and as you notice, it's got a Lazy Susan up underneath the kitchen there, and you can access it from out here or inside the camper. And what I like too about this, mate, is that you can leave, like, I don't know, maybe you're an A1 sauce guy or you need ketchup or mustard or whatever, you can reach in here if you put it on Lazy Susan.
Oh, that's a great idea.
You can just reach it from here because all your cooking is going
to
be out there. So
your grill.
That's a huge plus for
that's
this
nice.
Particular coach. Also on this coach, you got a solar panel plug-in. Plug and play is what we call it. Now I prefer the ones that go on the side only for the fact that when we like to camping, everybody likes to park underneath shade trees, and a lot of people do like to put solar panels on their roof. But this way you can just plug it in, you can direct it away from the coach, and then you can direct that panel throughout the course of the day to get maximum sun exposure.
Yeah, that's a great feature to have. As we move on to the front of the coach, we have,
you didn't see that,
two 30-pound propane tanks. So these are the bigger tanks, which is nice because then you can go that much longer. You can also, you have a power front tongue jack on the front. This is nice because you have a manual override, a light on the front to be able to see what you're doing if you're not at the daytime. And then you also have a secondary light too. So if you wanted to be able to hook up and unhook, you can use that. Behind here, if you kind of look behind or underneath the propane tank, there's a battery disconnect with a little red key. What that red key does is it disconnects all the power to your coach while you're in storage, basically, so that you don't have to accidentally run down your battery because you have things like your propane leak detector, you might accidentally leave a light on, and that will take all those worries away.
Yeah, the dry weight on this coach, mate, is actually 4,975 pounds. That's how it comes from the factory. But what's the GVWR on this?
This holds about 1,600 pounds worth of weight. So that this GVWR is 6,631. So if you're usually a half ton truck can pull this no problem, especially your newer half ton trucks.
Yeah.
Diamond plate on the front, outside shower. This is a great feature, guys. Even if you don't plan on taking a shower out here, just to clean off the fish, rinse off the feet before you go inside, there's all kinds of great uses for this other than an outside shower.
Yeah. You know, one of the fascinating things about Rockwood is the way that they build their coaches. And mate, you and I have both been to the factories. We've had that privilege of touring those. And you know, it's actually an experience that you'll never really forget because they're quick, they're efficient, and they build good quality coaches.
Yeah, in fact, if you ever wanted to go see how they build these, you can actually schedule a walkthrough and they'll show you the whole ins and outs. They have several people go in every week. I don't know if it's like a every Thursday type thing. It's different per factory, but it's amazing seeing these things built.
Yeah, so if we don't convince you enough to buy a Rockwood just by what we tell you, although you should because we're very knowledgeable in these these guys. We try to stay up to date as much as possible on here. But this is an all aluminum substructure coach. There is no wood as far as your supporting cast on this coach. It's double welded in the corners, and it's a vacuum bonded process. So a lot of people say, well, Tom, what does vacuum bonding mean? Well, in a nutshell, it's basically when they put this, when they put the walls together and including your roof, is they actually put it through a vacuum press. Now that vacuum press, what that does, it eliminates all of the air pockets between the inner and the outer wall. 75% of the other manufacturers, all they do is a pinch roll. They slap a bunch of glue on the fiberglass, put it together with the Luon, put it through the pinch press, and they call it good. Vacuum bonded, they actually, vacuum bonded with Rockwood, they actually take it a step further, put it on that vacuum press for about 30, 40 minutes. It's gonna give you a much tighter hold, and it's less likely for it to leak air on the coach as well. So if you can kind of see up underneath here, you can kind of see the double welds as far as what I'm talking about, and all the aluminum substructure on here too. Now this underneath is where your dinette is, and you're going to be sitting on this, folks. Okay, there's no wood that's going to break down on you over time. This aluminum substructure is super strong. It's held together very, very well. Being double welded here on the sides is going to give you that strength. And you're going to be, overall, you're going to be more than satisfied with a travel trailer like this, like the Rockwood.
Let me show you a few things over here, guys. Over here, we have your dump valves. So you have a kitchen dump valve as well as your bathroom dump valves. Now these have 12 volt heat pads on the tanks and the valves themselves. So right about a foot behind the valve, they have heat pads. And that's super important because that way, when you're pulling on that valve, it's not going to get stuck open or shut if you're going a little bit later in the season. Also, the fact that they're 12 volt is nice because that means you can have it plugged in as you're going over a cold pass and you're charging your batteries via your truck, and that's a great way to protect your tanks from creating a huge mess, really.
Yeah. Another thing that Rockwood is doing is they're giving you a 10-year axle warranty on the torsion flex suspension system, folks, okay? Now, these come from the factory with nitrogen air tires. Now, basically what that nitrogen's gonna do for you is gonna maintain that PSI for you. And I get a lot of questions as far as, can you add regular air to this? And the answer is, yes, you can. It's not gonna throw it off or anything like that. They just do that from the factory just to kind of help you out along the way. As we come down the side of the coach, you'll notice the sleek new graphics that are on this coach as well. You get more frameless windows. Over on the back side of the coach, this is where your black tank flush is gonna be. This is where your cable and satellite inlet connections are gonna be. And you're also gonna get on 30 amp service. Now, I actually had a customer say, Tom, you need to let folks know that you get a separate cable that's in here. And actually, it was a good point that he brought up, because the cables, or the 30 amp or the 50 amp cables that are actually, you have to push in and into a box, and on a cold day, that could be very hard to push in and pull out. This one comes with a separate cable that you can actually put in the coach and keep it out of the element, so it's not all hard and it's not all, you know.
Well, it's one less hole for critters to get inside. Yeah. Like you said, it doesn't get hard. I also like that they have the little LED light. This lights up if you have a good connection, because if you put it in crooked or you don't have power at the pedestal, this won't light up. So that's a nice feature too, to be able to troubleshoot things in a hurry.
So basically it's just a really long, huge extension cord bag.
Right here is our black tank sewer flush. That means instead of having to drag a hose into the camper, down the hallway in the bathroom, and then put a wand on there or something to be able to flush that out, you can just hook up to here. It has little sprayers inside the sewer tank itself, and it sprays it out for you. That's a lot more convenient and less mess to worry about.
Yeah. Notice on the back side of the 2506, you're going to get an access ladder to your roof. Now, folks, this roof is completely walkable. You can go on there and do all of your own maintenance, all of your own service checks, just to make sure that your roof is staying intact. Now, Rockwood is going to give you a 12-year roof warranty, okay? That means you shouldn't have to do anything to this guy that's going to come out of your own money, out of your pocket, spending your own dime. If there's anything that happens in there, Rockwood will take care of that for you for 12 years.
Now, with that said, you still want to go up there and maintain that roof.
Sure.
So that means any kind of seals around your skylight or your vents, you need to be able to check those, make sure that it's not drying out and cracking, because that can cause leaks that's not covered under the warranty.
Right. Mate, I'll give you $5 if you can fit into this tub.
Nope.
Nope, you can't
not
do it.
Happen.
You want me to try?
No.
No, okay. So anyway, this is a bin slide out. Now this actually goes underneath the bed in your coach here. This is additional storage that you have on this coach, which, man, you can put all kinds of stuff in here. So this is a great feature to have on this little guy, and it just locks right into place too. And of course, folks, magnetics right here, so you can just go ahead and close that right away. You're gonna have a direct spark ignition, 6-gallon water heater that's right here as well. This will be for your potable water. This little knob's gonna be for your potable water. And folks, this is like your canteen that's on board. So you're gonna go dry camping. You're not gonna have any access to water. So all the water that you're gonna bring is gonna go right in here. This is also gonna be your antifreeze inlet. Now this coach is super easy to winterize. Basically, you just bypass your water heater and then you hook up your jug of antifreeze to this. You turn your pump on and it basically works itself through the lines and takes care of that process for you. It's super easy to do. And then this is your city water connection. So if you are plugged into RV services somewhere, direct feed into the hose. You don't need to worry about turning on your water pump. It's basically running water like you have at your house. Direct now, connection.
One more thing that we want to point out before we go on to the front of the coach is you have a spot to put a wireless backup camera.
How cool is that?
Yeah, this is specifically made for a Furion backup camera. The one that we recommend is the Observation Furion backup camera because it has the best distance and it doesn't cut out. You can also turn it on so that you can see behind you even if you're not backing up.
Right.
And this cuts out the labor immensely. So it's got the wire already ran to it. So you take this plate off, plug your camera in, and then the little LED light or screen that you could buy with it that we carry in our parts store. You just put that right on your dash and you're set.
Good to go. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Tell you what, let's go inside and we'll show you some features in there.
All right, come on in, guys, and you can check out the front living room, I guess is what you'd call it.
Yep, this is the front living room. Obviously, you got a big U-shaped dinette right here. You're gonna have your entertainment system with the Furion TV. You're gonna have a sound bar here. You're also gonna have your radio, IRV Technologies radio right here, CD, DVD player, Bluetooth capable. You have a charging center, and oh, mate, this is how you turn on your Wi-Fi booster right here.
Yep. That is true.
The new upgraded on the
Rockwood. This is cool because if
Rockwood.
What that does is, so your
cell phone. Yes, Mr. Technology Man.
I will show you. So your cell phone antenna is about this big. And of course, inside a camper, that makes the signal not nearly as strong. So if there's a good Wi-Fi signal, well, good, let's say a poor Wi-Fi signal at the campsite, but it's a little too far, you're only getting one bar,
right,
or there's a Starbucks or McDonald's, whatever has a free Wi-Fi, and your cell phone's not getting a good enough signal for the Wi-Fi, you turn this on, connect into it, it has the password built into it right here, and then it has an antenna on top of the roof that's a much bigger antenna that will be able to give you a lot stronger signal to be able to use your phone, laptop, you name it.
Okay, there's gonna be a test on this later, so I hope you guys were all paying attention
right
on this
little Well, day. And if you forget how to do all that, it's nice because you have a little thing that you can scan and you can just go to this website and they'll walk you straight through it.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah.
So behind you, mate, is the Medic refrigerator.
Yep, this one is nice because it is a two-way, so it can run both off of propane or 110 power. It can auto change over from one to the other. That is nice if you're gonna do some dry camping and wanna make sure all your food stays cold. By the way, they include these little nice clips. What those do is they go right here, connect onto there, and then when this closes, it'll keep this door partially open. That's for when you're in storage so it doesn't build up mold and all that other kind of stuff.
Yeah.
As you move over to here, you'll notice this is all solid surface countertops. You also have a large 50 split basin sink with the high rise sink faucet. So if you want to be able to put bigger pot and pan in there, you can do that. Also doubles as a cutting board, of course. Lots of windows. So this is a huge window up on the front, as you can see. And then you also have the side window. This one is openable. So the way it works is it's like a rain window. So you can crank it open and it flips open like this. That way, even if it's raining, you're not getting everything wet inside here. Large 22-inch oven as opposed to the normal 17-inch oven. It gives you about twice as much space in here compared to the other ones that have a rack about halfway up. You do have a knife rack back here as well as a extra counter space just by having that flush mount range top cover. And then this is how to work the radio. So if you forget how to work the radio, here's a little paper on it to make it super easy for you.
You know, mate, one of the things that we talk about too is the wood construction in the Rockwoods, which is, second to none.
Wood construction?
The wood construction, yeah, the cabinets, right?
Ah, yes, okay.
So everything that's here is, so folks, this is all real. This is all real wood. This is all cabinetry that you would see in your residential home. Notice the nice hardware that comes on all the drawers and the cabinets that you'll get in this coach. Now, this is the particular, the U-shaped dinette that we were mentioning. You do have some storage underneath here as well. And on the other side. But this is the way that this one's set up right now. Is this is basically your second bed in this coach.
Well, let's show them how it turns into a bed. Let's show them how it turns into a dinette. So these just have a little Velcro in the back, so they just pop right onto there. And then this, you don't even have to take it all the way out like this. In fact, you can leave it flat, and then you can put a foot down, and it'll just shift right up.
Yeah, I like this particular table because you can take it outside, you can move it in the middle, and actually have another prep area in the kitchen. Mm-hmm. But then this just picks up, slides right in, and mate, I'm just gonna sit right here and I'll let you do the rest of the video because this is nice and comfy.
You know, I like it because if you just wanted a nice place to kind of sit and watch a movie or whatever, you could do that. Take this table and put it on your bed or put it outside, whatever. And I like that this is a little bit longer. So even if you have a couple adults staying overnight with you, they have their own separate bedroom area and they have a long enough area to actually sleep as opposed to the normal couch that's not nearly long enough for an adult.
No, for sure.
Yeah. All right, come on back here, guys. We want to show you what the bathroom bedroom area looks like.
This has got a cool skylight in here, mate.
Absolutely.
But I'm protecting myself. I don't want to get too much sunburn on my forehead.
There you go.
So I got my hat on in here. So as you can see, me being a taller guy, and I demonstrate this in all of my videos, just so the taller guys can kind of get a perspective. You know, being 6'2 or probably 6'3 with the boots on, the cowboy hat on, I'm probably right around 6'4 at this point. But you got plenty of room in the shower here. So I can put my elbows out. I can actually turn all the way around. And you got plenty of room in here. Got the hot and cold water options on here with your shower. So yeah. And you got the glass doors on here too, and they're held together by this little magnet that's right here. And one of the things that Rockwood likes to do is they actually like to give you a lot of cabinet space in here. You have a Dometic foot flush toilet there, medicine cabinet with a mirror. Of course, they give you a nice little towel holder too, place for your toothbrushes and soap. And then you'll have a Formica countertop with a basin sink in here, both hot and cold water features. And of course, you'll also have some storage up underneath here as well. So plenty of space in this. And for a mini light, this has got a lot of space. And let's not forget the max air fan. Now the max air fan is going to draw air through the camper. So what you can do is you can actually open up the windows and not only will it exhaust the hot steam from your shower or whatever else, but you open up the windows and it'll create a nice little breeze coming through here.
Yeah, that will move over 900 cubic feet of air per minute as opposed to the little tiny ones that do about 25 cubic feet of air per minute. And this is one of the cooler features I feel like in this area. It's the back bedroom. So this does lift up. So if you wanted to have a little bit of storage here, you can. Again, you'll notice it's all aluminum framed as opposed to wood framed. If you look under any of the competition, you'll notice it's not like that. And you also have nice little drawers that come out too. So you have three of these and they have the nice ball bearing glide so they shut very easily. This mattress is a heated mattress, so you have a little plug-in right back here that allows you to plug it in, and you do have an outlet over here, and I think you might even have one on the other side.
Yep,
you do, and a nice drawer on that side too. In addition to that, you have some storage space on both this side and that side, as well as more storage, I guess, right up here too. So, yeah, and then look at the size of the windows too. These are very nice. And they're both openable, so you can get a nice cross breeze. And then, of course, the nice pleated day-night shades are great as well. And then one more thing I'll point out is the AC is all double ducted. So if you open these up here, you can turn them to get you your cold air here. But if you're just using the living room, you can shut all these. That way you're forcing all that cold air into one area to be able to help you out to cool down and manage the hot and cold out here.
Okay, before we depart the video, a couple things. This is going to be your control panel here, and this is going to actually be your monitoring station for your battery. Now, we do have a battery hooked up to this coach, and you'll see as I push the button, I got about 2/3 power to the battery, so I'm good to go. Nothing in the fresh water, nothing in the black, and nothing in the gray tanks. So those little sensors on the tanks will help you know when you need to dump your tanks. Your water pump is going to be located right here. Your both your gas or electric controls for the water heater are going to be located right here. Your tank heaters, as Mate explained, that are attached to your holding tanks up underneath, you turn that on through your 12-volt system. All of your interior lights, your porch light, your scare light, and then your slide-out buttons are going to be located right here as well.
You know, I like that you can control some of the lights from there, and I like that you have individual control over these lights too.
Yeah, it's just a extra way that you can make it convenient. So if you don't want all the lights on, you just want like a little damper light or something, you can just leave that one on. Also, you have an HD television antenna on the coaches too. Now, there's no hand crank or anything like that that you have to use to raise the antenna. This one actually sits just below the air conditioner unit, and you can just turn it for best reception. Of course, this is only going to work if wherever you're at provides a local television station, so keep that in mind. So one of the things that you don't want to do is you don't want to delay on getting this 2506. These have been a hot topic since we've gotten these in here.
They kind of surprised Rockwood. They didn't realize how, in fact, they're trying to figure out some new floor plans. So that has that separate bedroom in a small unit. So if you have some ideas, feel free to comment down below and say, hey, that would have been an awesome unit if it only had this. We can send those over to Rockwood, and they actually listen. A lot of times they come out with that new idea 6 months later.
They do. If you have any questions on this particular model or any of the other Rockwoods that we carry or the other brands that we have, feel free. If you don't like Mate, you can email me too and tell me that. My email is actually tom@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. Actually, I'm just picking on you, Mate. It's been a while since we've done a video
together.
Yeah,
that's right.
Yeah. Or you can reach out and give us a call at 970-313-4337.
If you wanted to check out more floor plans in this same size, but this one didn't quite do it for you, you can go to thegreatoutdoorsrv.com, and then we have all of our videos, all of our pictures, pricing, all that stuff. We keep up to date on our website.
Yep, and we love the comments on YouTube. Whether we agree with them or not, you're feel free to go ahead and post them on there. And if you like this video, give us a thumbs up for sure.
All right, thanks guys.
Take care.